There are also minimum scale and maximum scale properties too, which is a way to limit the extents that the system is allowed to scale the page on the device. This seems a little esoteric at first, but there is one use that I wanted to mention. I don't want you to think that I'm biased, so after describing how you need to add initial scale for iOS to work as expected, I wanted to give equal time for Android. If your page with device width happens to forcibly overflow the page, like this page, where I've added an element that's very wide, Android will actually do some rescaling when you change screen orientation to try to get the whole page to fit onto the screen. Now, unfortunately, it gets it wrong, and it tries to zoom it the wrong way. Now, the only way that I've found to get around this, other than not overflowing the screen to begin with, is to set the minimum scale and maximum scale properties to 1, which will prevent the user from zooming altogether, as well as disabling automatic scaling. Let's do that in the DevTools now. Now let's try rotating again. We're back to normal here. And now you see that even in landscape mode, we get the proper width. Now, the problem with this, of course, is I can't zoom anymore. You really don't want to disable zooming for your users. This is an accessibility problem. So don't do this in production pages, but it can help your testing. In general, just don't overflow the page, and you'll be good.